Hey everybody, it's 5:05. Yeah, that means that we're 5 minutes late, but you know what? What's 5 minutes between friends? It's purely my loss because I missed you for 5 whole minutes. This is Ann Klemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com. We are going to do a fun fast fall card today. Yeah, try saying that 3 times fast. So hey, let's get started. Stamper, come. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, let the games begin. Oh, thank you for waiting for me. Yeah, it's been a crazy day with no Facebook. You know, isn't that funny? They went and they had certain things become public and they talked more about them. And next thing you know, we just get a little taste of what it would be like without them. Hey, so... It's working right now, but you know what? I love it when you come on and hang out with me in YouTube, you know, because, yeah, well, and I love it when you just show up. Yeah. Well, the dog was here all the time. I'm trying to get ready. Yeah, we're having a great time. He's supposed to see the doctor. It was supposed to be tomorrow, but that was for vaccinations. And I don't know that I want to do a vaccination right now. Yeah, not for him. And then, but then on Thursday, he's supposed to see the doctor who saw him when he was sick. So that's what we're waiting for. And she called. When did she call? 4 minutes to 5. And I try to tell him, don't call on my cell phone. I may never see the message. Oh, Kay's here from Houston. Deb, Marcy. Oh, golly. All the regulars, all those people that I mailed stuff to today. Yeah. I did put some stuff in the mail. Yeah, for Patty and Deb. And yeah, and Kathy's here. Yeah. Everybody's here. Everybody's here. Susan's here. Yeah. And how about this? When the dog's supposed to go back, I think I double booked myself. The time I'm supposed to get the hair appointment that I should have had a week or two ago. Oh yeah, it's like, and I, oh, let's just not go there. It's gonna be flipping up in the back soon. Yeah, Facebook is working now. Yeah, they're over there. Yep. So what we're gonna do? We're gonna take some leftovers from a card that I designed last night for Master Stampers, right? And that is our group of people who really like to stamp. I mean, you want to learn, that's where you go. We've got hundreds of videos with written instructions for you to keep. And yeah. Oh, see, look at Marcy just wants to rub it in. She gets Sunday delivery. How about that? Yeah. Yeah, Kay does too. They're all down there in Texas where, you know, yeah. Well, I just... Well, let's not go there, but I sometimes think in Texas they play football with our boxes. Oh, golly. Yeah. Okay. So here we go. Here we go. We're going to remake the card, and then I'm going to show you the card that that we're remaking, not necessarily the card that I got the leftovers from. And these aren't even the leftovers. I'm just going to switch this right over here. But see, look at... Now, one of the things when I was talking last week, golly, I don't know what card that we were working on, but you want to be careful when you're cutting out things with metallic. Oh, thank you, Kay. Yeah, see, look at, see, yeah, I love it when you share it. And I love it when you know, like and subscribe and throw up some hearts. And, yeah. Anyway, if you look really close there, see, because this is a well-used, well-loved platform and it's not dead yet, right? But those things, when you're doing foil, they get into your, they'll mark up the unused parts. So you want to like, just cut your foil the side. I'm sorry, Stamper. Hold on. Oh, golly, you are kind of big today. Yeah. Hold on. For those of you who have been asking, yes, he's better. He's not 100%, but he's really, you know, he still gets excited. You know, when when it comes to food, yep. And he wags his tail and he loves it when, you know, we get company and stuff. But I can tell he's a little, he probably wants to go outside right now, right? Don't you, bud? Don't you? Yeah, let me get you over. Which way? This way, that way, that way, that way. I moved the camera. I had to. Yeah. Yeah, he doesn't like it if he can't stand on my hip. Yeah, and he's thinking somebody else's. Calling him Cecil? Cecil? He wants to come see you. He wants to go outside. Yeah. So anyway, yeah, dog hair everywhere. Okay, so yeah, and look at they're saying no state income tax in Texas. I know they have it in North Carolina, yeah. Because I'd never heard of it. I'm from Washington State. And when I married my husband and he said something about state taxes, I'm like, what are you talking about? I didn't even know there was such a thing. Oh, golly. So, hey, did you have a nice World Card Making Day? Because I was packing up things from the sale. And if this is your first time here, we do a monthly sale on the first Friday of the month. And so, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Oh, golly. Yeah, I got stuff on me. Yeah, he's doing fairly well. As long as he's happy, I'm happy. When he's not happy, no. But see, I'll give you a little glimpse of this. Yeah, we're using the leftovers from this card. Yeah, that's what I did for Master Stamper. And this is about how to do that without getting ink on your hands. Yeah. So for this, we're going to fold some. Why do I feel I'm in the dark here? Because I am. Hold on one second. I am in the dark here. My hair will look better next time you see it. See, look, it got more, and look at, does my hair look better now? No, now you can see every single little bit. Oh, I'll be glad to get my bangs cut. So anyway, back to this. Yes, I handfold, not all the time. When it's a long, skinny one going this way, you definitely want to score. And I know many of you like to score. So I'm going to put this on here. This is from that Christmas set. Oh, golly, I've got it here. Hold on. This is Tidings of Christmas, number 155718. Oh, there. Now I know how to get the light on it if I get out of the way. 155718. Yes, and I think I'm going to be doing one of those other cards. Golly, what am I trying to think of with using this? Pinwheel, yeah. So I'm going to put this right here. I don't know what it is about this time of year, but I do like to use Sahara sand this time of year. Oh, hey, how cool is that? You know, yeah, World Card Making Day was Saturday, and I was, you know, I see you. Whoa, my camera. I told you I moved. Yeah, if one thing moves, then everything goes. I think I need to get a new holder for this camera. Hold on. Sorry. Oh, golly, that's way too high. Something moved on this camera when I moved a light. You should be glad I'm not showing you what's coming through that camera right now. Give me a second now. Get it regrouped. I will say one thing about doing this is that I get better at fixing things, but that's not the best, I'll tell you that. It's too high. So you're only going to see a talking head. Yeah, because, I had to do what I had to do. I liked it. It'd be nice if I could get this, but yeah, I'm going to have to get a new holder. So now, sorry about the technical stuff. There you go. So I'm going to put it on here, and I'm going to put these on here. And why I wanted to have dark, right? I wanted to have dark And not all of these are dark, right? Is because these are the leftovers from making that, see? And so they'll pop more if they're on a dark background, right? Yes. I have lots of them. And then here I made these just in case. But the big difference between these, oh, no. The backing is that these copper ones have, adhesive sheets on the back. Come on. Doesn't want to pop out. There it goes. Copper ones have adhesive sheets on the back, and these don't have any. We'll have to put them on with glue. There. Deal with those later. We might, may or may not use these. They might go into our stash. So did you make cards for World Card Making Day? And you know, this is what I call World Card Sending Week. You know, you'd really need to mail them out. Don't be like me. You need to mail them out. Could have done these in solids and then put that on top, but I don't think that that would work quite as well. Boy, that would be a lot of, yeah, it just doesn't pop as much for me. At least that's my humble experience. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to put this on here, and then I'm going to emboss it with an embossing folder. And so this is where you get to input. What embossing folder do you think I should use? I'll let you, you know, you can pick one, preferably a, well, the dog decided to come to work today, huh? 3D one, yeah. These are 3 by 1.5. So this is 3 1/4 by 4 3/4. I was thinking, the texture one, the text. Oh, look at that. I could have swore I cut those out at the same time, but for some reason, I don't like that. I think it's going to be this way. Look at, I thought I cut them out at the same time so they'd all be the same size, but look at, there's a error there. And that, yeah, does, that looks a little bit, the exact side of my personality is reacting to that. Oh my goodness. Now over on YouTube, they all went silent. Let me look and see if I'm just not picking things up. That's funny. Very funny. Very okay there. Oh, now I see it. Okay. Yeah, when you want things the same size, go and cut them out at the same time if you can. This is just a, wow. It's like I don't know, my my exact part of my personality is just kind of going into overdrive. That never happens to you, does it? Golly, and I even my little trimmer, it's like, where the heck did it go? I trim that down just a little bit. I don't think it's going to help, but it might help a little bit. Wish Stampin' Up! Still carried this trimmer. So Which designer, which, oh, video interruption notice. That's interesting. It's not on this end. I can tell you that. I can tell you that. Hold on. That's quite interesting. And that's on Facebook. Okay, then I would definitely put a strip of gold down the side. Oh, well, you know what? We can cover this up really easily. But I put it on this side so that I can go and do this. And I see what you're talking about, that strip of gold. Yeah, because I want the purple at the top. See, but once all I have to do is put this bad boy on there, nobody's going to care. It's Facebook. I would go over to YouTube personally. That's what I do. But we have to go in and strip a gold down the side. Oh, well, I do have that, but then that's going to kind of fight against this, and this is copper. Okay, now that the camera's all got wonky, where's my, there it is. I'm like, where's my sweet spot? This is copper, so yeah, but we do have this copper. We do have this copper. It's not copper, but it's rose gold. This just happened to be something that was on my, and see, this is what you do. You go and put a sheet, a slightly smaller than this. This is like 4x2. Well, actually the adhesive sheet is 4x2. And then that piece was just a little bit bigger than that. You think that doesn't seem to fight with it. Okay, we're going to do what Beverly says this time. You know, everybody gets a chance to, and this is an inch, so I'm going to say a half an inch. Quarter, half. Yeah. What's the worst that can happen? What's the worst that could happen? Okay, let's see how this does. Put that on the middle. Put that there. Put this here. You like that? Do you like that? Yeah, it did. Facebook is having issues today, and so I would not trust them for a signal personally. I think we might not even use these. Golly, who knows? Who knows? But which, we still haven't addressed this. Which, you know, now I'm thinking maybe not using the text one because it's very linear, but this might be an idea. Okay, here we go. I gotta tell you, whatever you're using for an embossing machine, when it fails, you gotta get this new cut and emboss machine that Stampin' Up! Has. I was thinking, well, I'll buy it because it's my business and that's what I should do. And then I went, yeah, no, I really like it. It's just got subtle differences that make it worth it. Okay, keep your fingers crossed and your hands in the prayer position that I'm able to put this on here straight. It'd be nice if I knew where that ended. There. Now, it's times like this is that I kind of wish I had my grid pad out here. Yeah, I have it. It's underneath this black piece of paper. And the reason I do that is so that I was watching someone's video the other day. And that's not in the middle. You think anybody will notice? I don't think so. Anyway, and it was shot at such low resolution that all the grid pad things were like going wonky. I mean, just really weird. It was just very weird. But it does make it a whole lot easier to line up things. There, okay. Yeah. Oh. Didn't I want this at the top? But I think it's the other way around. And that'll be easier anyway. And I'm just going to put some glue on there. Now, you notice I don't use these on here. And I bring this up because I know some of you do this. But I use the green top ink because when you use something with pressure on it, then you're debossing what you just embossed. And then sometimes like, see, it looks pretty. And then it'll have this strip down the middle where it doesn't have, you know, where it's been debossed. And it's like you're working against yourself. You're working too hard. Yeah, I hear, you know, I'm still going ahead with this not being exactly right because I know when I was first starting stamping, I just didn't know enough to make it, you know, to know what I was doing wrong. It was just kind of weird. And I'd be going, how do I fix that? I don't know. And what am I doing wrong? And what size do I cut the paper? And oh, golly, it was just what a mess. Okay, so I think I might just use these. I don't know. What do you think? I mean, it's like, these just don't have I might put one of them down there. I don't know. Okay, so here, you notice I did not unplug all of these right here, right? I didn't take them off. And I'm going to show you why in just a second. I hope I'm going to show you why in just a second. Now, Kay in Houston, I didn't look to see where you're watching me from. Did you find me on YouTube? Because she says she needs the link. You really only have to just go to YouTube and then search StamperDog. Now look at all those are going to come out on that. See, I didn't even have to pop them out. I only had to pop out that one little one that just was a little stubborn and needs a little attitude adjustment. There you go. Yeah, put the leaves. Of course I'm going to put the leaves. It's just, where are they at? Usually I like to kind of lay them out first to see how easily that goes on there because I've got that. Yeah. One down here. One down there. I could put one over here. We don't even have a greeting, folks. I mean, and see, you don't even notice this one so much. It's there, but I don't think I need a whole bunch of them. Right here should be the greeting. And what kind of greeting? This is awful light. You know, in hindsight, that's awful light, but that's because I wasn't expecting to have this, but even then it's a bit light. And you notice that when I did put this through, I put it through with the back and the base and these, and I do that because sometimes when you put these through, because that up and down has to go from come from somewhere, it makes the cardstock shift maybe a 32nd of an inch, but it makes it shift. So this way, by putting this base and the cut pieces together, they all shift at the same time. Hello. Golly, what was that? I can't believe somebody would text me. It's probably Kay saying, I can't get in. It's my daughter who is totally oblivious to the fact that her mother's working right now. It's her day off. That's okay. Oh, golly. Put the leaves, please. But we have to think about a greeting. A greeting. Greet me. I do have to show you something. This is what, when I couldn't think of what to make last night. Oh, please. Okay. When I couldn't think of what to make last night, this is what I did while I was. Yeah, is that gorgeous? And I did it on watercolor paper. I think it would even look better on shimmery white, because it would shimmer just a little bit. But I'm quite pleased with that. And I'm going to tell you, the lightest is the light red. And then I use dark red and light and dark cherry cobbler. And this is, I believe, the dark red right there on those. And then these are the shaded spruce, dark and light. And the light... sorry, Stamper. Hold on. The light soft succulent for this and the dark soft succulent for that. So yeah, that's going to go on something, but boy, I mean, I definitely wouldn't put it on a tag where somebody throw it away. It's definitely going to be on a card. Someone that I know will keep it. Now, these are nice. These are nice, but they're not quite as big as what I would like. Let's think of a nice, bold one. Now, see, this is where I need you. I need you to kind of help me. By the way, it's taco day. Did you know that? Did you know it's taco day? Oh, wow. Okay. Hold on. There's that. There's this. What stamp set is the Christmas one from? I'll bring that out. This might be a happy birthday. Yeah. It's from Words of Cheer, this right here. But you want to know why I got this? Here, I'll give you the number. Whoa, 156357. Yeah, that's it. 156357. But I'm going to tell you now, you'll want the bundle, because the bundle comes with, yeah, as you notice, I haven't put the magnets on here. Happy. There's a happy. Yeah. There's a happy. And then it also has cheer. See, and here's one way and here's another way. Right. This is like more like holiday like. Right. And see, that's more holiday like. Then this is a finer one that you can use with anything. Yeah. I don't even know if that's the right one for this either. That's so big. That is so big. Oh, maybe this. Well, I was going to do Forever Friends. That would be nice. Yeah, well, that has to do, okay, this has to do with the fact that Facebook is having issues today. Okay, let's see if we can stamp these at the same time. That'll make it fun. Okay, where's Forever on here? Happy Friends, Forever Friends. There you go, right there in front of me. That's where it is. She said nice thanks. Oh yeah, you're right. I can't get it down there quite as closely as I'd like. Let's see if it works. Hard thing is not letting it stick to your hand. Calling all pieces of extra, you know, extra pieces of cardstock. Yeah, here's one. We'll see how that goes. Yes, Patty, I am. They started October 1st. Now somewhere, right? Yep, right here under four stamp sets that I've showed you. I'm not even making the card that I really thought about making. Ooh. Now you notice I'm not going too close to the edge, and that's because I'm hoping, see, look at that. That's not too bad. It's a little bit wonky, but where did I put that down? This is one of my favorites. Tasteful Labels dies. Whoa, this is way too big. That's way too big. This one right here. See, that's too much white. This, and we can cut it off on one side. Yeah, maybe that. Yes, I really would like to go on that Baltic trip. Oh yeah. It's someplace I've never been. When my husband and I lived in England, they used to have trips to Russia, and he was not game for that, you know, because we were stationed at a military base over in England. Yeah. Hold on, I'm lining up here. I hope I get this straight, and if I don't, well, I'll just pretend to put it on. When I think I moved it, let's see. It's a little bit. It's okay. Done is better than perfect, my friends. Hold on. We're just going to make it up as we go along. If we don't like that, that's okay. But look at how this works. Now I wish I would have put that wonky side on this side, because then I definitely cut it. If I put it like right here. I think putting it down here is even better. You'll tell me when I get the mix right, right? I know I had some small ones of these. That's a big one. Because see, look at there. Nope. There it is right there. The evidence. Nope, it's not there. It's funny that like they just kind of disappeared. Okay, I think putting it way over here. Placement's everything. But for some reason, I cut those out. See, look at, I have the evidence, but the two I'm looking for are not here. And see, I want something that covers that right there. But maybe it'll call attention to it. Yeah, not all the way on the edge. You think all the way on the edge, or do you want the edge of the... where it lines up with the... I found one. Oh, I found them both. Oh, Anita, I'm glad you like it. I kind of like it lining up here, but then there's something to be said for this, but then you wonder how it's going to travel, because that'll make it want to bend a bit if I go all the way to the edge. Okay, the way I have it now. Which is, yeah, okay, good. Okay, so here we go. That. I like this one better. Okay, does this work? We'll see. Now, if you've been around me at all, you know that I go and I mix up. Yeah, I mix up my adhesives, and like on this one, I mix up my adhesive because this is going to be higher than this here. So I'm going to put dimensionals, and I'm sorry, I'm going off camera right there. I'm going to put dimensionals right here on the edge, right? Give it a really good base there. In fact, I'll even put three up there. I mean... is funny putting this down and I can't even see where the edge is. I'm like going, oh please, I hope I get it right. And then I'll take the glue and go on this side. See? Yeah. And I want this to line up so this is halfway in here. I can't tell you whether it's an art thing, it just makes sense to me. Yeah. Okay. This one's down. This one's committed, right? This one's committed. Actually, it doesn't need as many as you might think. I think that might be better. I hope you agree with me. When I'm doing these fine things, okay, here, I'm going to show you again where, whoa, come on, get in frame, get in focus. There you go. See, I separated it and then pull this apart, and most of those will come out on there. So you don't really have to, you know, we're poking them out. We're doing all this stuff, and then come to find out, oh, what a wasted effort. If you just go and pull the adhesive sheet off the back. Now, you don't have to have, well, I'm going to stick that on the back of my hand. It'll quit bothering me. You don't have to have the adhesive sheet cover everything, okay? It doesn't have to cover everything. It just have to cover cover most of it. Oh, Patty was reading my mind. Patty was reading my mind. See, I almost started to go and poke these bad boys out. The only thing is the brushed metallics, they're brushed. And they go more with this. And I'm afraid that that might detract. I don't know. We'll see. See, that's a different kind of copper. It that would give me three different metals on there. And let's see if I can do this. Yeah, when I'm doing this, I can't see this, if just so you know. Because the glasses I wear for you are so that I can see the screen, not so I can see bifocals. Yeah. They're not bifocals. They're just so I can see the screen. See, look at that. On all of them, just one. Isn't that better than having to go and pop out all these? Oh, and thank you. Kathy likes the color combo. I hope you're having a decent picture over there. I understand over on Facebook that many people are having issues. So, golly, I moved the camera. So now. So anyway, yeah. I think. I'm thinking. Hold on. Nope. Oh, I was thinking something had purple on it, but there's always. Hold on. I pulled my rhinestones out and they're in the other way. Okay. Kathy's not having any problem, but there. So we've got this gold. I wish that was copper. I really do. I'm just that matchy person. Elegant faceted gems. That's it. See, look at that's going to bring them all in. That's going to bring it all in. That, you know, I was thinking about that, Patty, the champagne rhinestone jewels, but I think this is going to be it right here. Do I want a big one? Because it's just kind of coppery and it's just kind of, I don't know, maybe I should put it down here. Hold on. See, because this isn't exactly in the center and I don't want to, there it is. I don't want to call attention to the fact that that's not in the center. Just that little itty bitty bit there, you know, and so you've got three different sparklies, you got three different colors. This is so if you want to do this, but I'd highly recommend try to find something. You could take a strip of copper and texture it. Just a little strip and texture it, and that would probably even make this more dynamic, okay? But still, I like it, and if I you know the way I look at it, if oh look at it. See, I have to get my tippy toes now. Let's try this. If I put a $50 bill in this, I'm sure somebody would like it. And you know, before we're done, I got a little prize I'm going to give away, so don't go anywhere. But anyway, if you look at it, we've got Blackberry Bliss. We have, this is of course Sahara Sand. We have Cajun Craze and Early Espresso. And it's just kind of, you can tell it's fall. And it's just, yeah, I mean, hey, yeah. I like the way that Patty thinks. Yeah, you know, and if you do need to go shopping, you know, the dog loves it when you give him a give him a shout out. You know, he was here a little while ago and then he left. Hey, what do I have coming up? I have something coming up and here it is. Yeah, it is our 10th anniversary. And like I said, the not my 10th anniversary. I've been doing this for 22 years. But this is 10th anniversary for Master Stamper. And if you go, make sure you put the www in there. You can get it for $5 a month until the end of the year. And then the rest of the time, if you like it, then great. You've had 3 months for the price of one, right? then keep on. And then if you don't like it well, at the end of the year, you can go, okay, time to switch. But there are hundreds, literally hundreds of projects in there with written instructions and video. And I was doing live streams on there with my master stampers way back 8 years ago. Yeah, we were, yeah. So if I showed you one of those now, I would crawl under a rock in embarrassment. Oh, it was, you know, you're doing it with webcams and you're, yeah. And be watching the dogs. You know, if you're not on our mailing list, you want to make sure you get on our mailing list because you want to make sure and get on our mailing list because we're going to put out the second week of Christmas this week. And there is something happening on the 6th, I think it is. I think it could be the 5th, but I think it's the 6th. And I can't tell you what it is, but I can tell you there. Oh, Patty, I love how you think. I love how you think. So anyway, what we're going to do, we're going to go and look, because today's been a really cray-cray day. We got 65 in here. And we are going to go and I've got some like Christmassy designer series paper from years gone by that I'm going to mail out to one of you. But if you're the winner, remember that you need to go and email me. And I'm going to start with number 3 from the first end, and then we'll see how it is. Golly, that is, I wish I could get my camera back to where it was before I moved it. Hold on 1 second. Got to count. What? Oh, I think she's here. In fact, I know she's here. Marcy. Yeah. Marcy. Yeah. But Marcy, still go in and send me your address so I don't have to look it up. Yeah. So yeah, just and let everybody know that you're here so that I can, give you the right shout out. She was here. Well, she was here 4 minutes ago. And so I know she didn't leave. Oop, it's not that one. It's, because this is what, so, hey, yay. Woo-hoo! So we are here live Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yeah. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Yep. She's here. I told you she's here.
Winner.
Yeah. She's here. And, oh yeah. What's the other thing? Yeah. If you already have this set, you need to come and join our October Stamp Camp. You can, if you already have it, then you'll have what you need to make the projects along with us. If you don't, you can still come in and hang out with us, and we'll get to that as fast as we can. But yeah, it's going to be a great time. Noelia, Diane, and Karen and I, we are just, we're pulling out all the stops. So anyway, like I said, on Wednesday, Friday, and Monday, yeah, we're here live at 5. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper from StamperDog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun into your day. See you Wednesday, 5 o'clock.